Due to the pandemic, many Veterans Day celebrations were held virtual or drive-in here in Tuscaloosa, but many residents were still able to come out to the VF post in Cottondale and pay their respects. Every year, Para holds a Veterans Day ceremony at Veterans Memorial Park just outside of University Mall. To follow social distancing guidelines, they set up a drive-in. Para hasn't canceled their Memorial Day program and wanted to find a safe way to honor local men and women who have served. The VFW 6022 post served as a place for residents to come and honor veterans too. Commander at the post, Donnie Nelson, says he is honored to put on this event and spend time with what he calls his brothers and sisters.
No matter what branch, some of us serve together, but some of us have served years apart, but it's like we have that instant connection when we sit down and talk to one another.
At the event, awards were given out to local veterans and first responders who helped protect and serve. Awards like Voice of Democracy and Certificates of Appreciation to first responders. Aside from the awards and appreciation veterans often receive, Nelson said the most important part is the service.
That's why veterans are veterans. That's what they do, because they want to serve. They serve the country and communities, and that's what we're about.
Even the youth at the Capitol School had a chance to honor veterans around T-Town. Because of the pandemic, they were unable to invite veterans to visit them, so instead they combined this holiday with the German holiday Walking with Lanterns, which also falls on November 11th. The students stood and walked through the streets with homemade red, white, and blue lanterns that symbolize bringing light into the world. In Tuscaloosa, Sydney Spencer, WVUA 23 News.